Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. I hope you enjoyed our coverage from CES last week. In just a bit, we'll check in with Martin Williams, who's at the auto show in Detroit. Is Samsung buying BlackBerry for $7.5 billion? Executives on both sides said no. Samsung and BlackBerry quickly denied rumors from a Reuters report on Wednesday that executives of the two companies had met about a possible acquisition. Would it be a good deal, though? Well, yes. The once mighty Canadian mobile vendor may need a suitor if it can't weather its current transition, and Samsung could gain a lot from BlackBerry's security assets and enterprise relationships. While BlackBerry still sells handsets, it sees its future growth in enterprise software services. And now it's over to Martin Williams at the North American International Auto Show in Detroit. Martin.
Thanks, Nick. There's a lot of really interesting stuff here at the Motor Show. Here's a look at some of the things that caught my eye. Chevrolet introduced an update to its hybrid Volt, but the real star of its stand is the new Bolt. The all-electric car can drive around 200 miles on a single charge. It's Chevy's answer to the Nissan Leaf and other electric cars. It comes with a smartphone app that will unlock the doors, enable ride-sharing reservations and payments, and also include a self-parking function. Press the button and the car should be able to park itself. Prices will begin around $30,000. Honda's FCV is a glimpse into the future of hydrogen-powered vehicles. It'll go on sale in Japan and the US in 2016 and joins Nissan's Mirai as the second planned commercial hydrogen vehicle. A fuel cell converts hydrogen to electricity to power a motor, and the only output is water. Clean as the car is, production of hydrogen still relies on fossil fuels, so it's not a totally green technology yet. There's plenty of tech in the Mercedes F015 concept. Just look at this car. It's a futuristic sort of all-electric pod that's shiny plastic screens and lots of LEDs. Developed as a luxury car, it's meant to be autonomous, so you can just enjoy the ride or your fellow passengers. The seats swivel around so you can face each other. So that's the highlights of the auto show. Back to you, Nick.
Thanks, Martin. A robot you can build like Legos. We go inside San Francisco startup ModBot to take a look at how they're creating the muscles and bones of a humanoid robot. Check out our latest edition of Breakout Startups at the link below. The newest Android handset from China's Xiaomi is looking to overshadow Apple's iPhone 6 Plus. The handset maker unveiled its Xiaomi Mi Note in Beijing Thursday. It has a 5.7-inch screen and is a fraction of a millimeter thinner than the iPhone 6 Plus. The phone will debut in China later this month for 2,300 yuan or $376 US when bought without a contract. That's a bargain in China considering the iPhone 6 Plus is more than 2.5 times that price. Xiaomi's new phablet will help the company grow its ever-increasing market share. In Q3 last year, it ranked as the world's third largest smartphone vendor, behind Apple and Samsung, according to IDC. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out, we'll leave you with some more shots from the auto show. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.